Hi. You don't know me, and I don't know you. But the reason I'm here to send this message is because I know that there's pain and there's hate in this world. One thing I do know is that I'm an advocate. Although I am not anybody who would be a brother or sister who is identifying bi, gay, questioning, transgender, lesbian, I myself am a youth minister, and I feel very strongly about hate versus love. I think that no matter what, love overcomes it all, and there's too much hate in this world. The videos to follow are videos of dear friends of mine, friends of a community of advocates, and people who themselves have dealt with these issues. People who went through ministry processes and came out in their own sermons to their congregation and were accepted and loved. There are many congregations in this world and in this country that do not accept, but what I want you to know is that there are a lot of congregations that do. From Presbyterians, to Episcopals, to UCC, or UU. The people to follow, some of them are just advocates, and some of them themselves have dealt with the stories and the troubles. I myself am a youth minister who have seen teens go through these things. People that I love go through these things. When I was in high school, I had a friend come out to me and asked me not to tell anybody, and he told me the only reason he came out to me is because he knew that I would love him no matter what. And you know what? You are loved. I don't care if your parents or your church is telling you something different. God loves you and made you perfect. And these are voices that no matter what, share love.
I see a pastor at Second Presbyterian Church in Baltimore. In our baptism, we believe that we belong always to God and that there is nothing that could ever separate us from the love of God. One of the greatest gifts of my life is the loving congregation that I grew up in. It was a church that not only taught us from the pulpit, but showed us in their actions and in their words that we, all of us, are a valuable part of God's creation and that God loves us very much. It is my belief that our role as disciples and our role as the church in the world is to do our best to share this unconditional love of God by the way that we love one another. To whoever it is that is watching this video, I would want you to know that you are first and foremost a child of God, that God has created you just as you are, and that there are congregations and churches and people out there that understand that you are a part of the body of Christ, and we honor that and we value that. It is our gift, it is our mission, it is our role as the church.
As a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ and as an openly gay man, I want to share with you a lesson that we find in the gospel of Matthew. When Jesus is asked about the greatest commandment, he says this, that you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind. And then he adds a second commandment like it and says, you shall love your neighbor as yourself. To love neighbor as yourself is a manifestation of how we love God. But to love neighbor as yourself means that you first must come from a place of loving you. We need to first come from a place of affirming our belovedness. We did not choose to be part of the LGBTQ family. It was a gift that was given to us, founded in our very creation. Love the gift that you are. And in doing so, we can then love our neighbor as ourselves, and we can love our great God. But it all starts from loving who God has made you to be.
I do want to say, like, right off the bat that I am a straight person, which means that I have no idea what you're going through. I've never had to do anything like this, but I wanted to say thank you, because every time somebody does stand up for who they are, and every time you just approach this world honestly like that. You push the door open a little bit more for the next person. This world is better for what you're doing and for having you in it. And so I wanted to thank you because this is important work. It's bitter work. It's not work that everybody has to do, and it's hard. And I'm so grateful that you are doing it and that you are coming out and you are being yourself. I am also a seminarian, which means I'm studying to be a pastor. I've got like a couple years left and I'm very excited. I've always wanted to do this. And so when I heard that you were being told that what you're doing is wrong and that the Christianity that you know is not friendly to LGBTQ people, I was so heartbroken. I just wanted to make it clear to you that there is a place for you in this community. There is absolutely a place for you. You are not a mistake. You are not making sin. You are just loving people. How is loving people a sin? When I read the Bible, it's full of these stories of people just being who they are and embracing their identities and their convictions, and God is right next to them through it all. And as far as I'm concerned, this was no different. And I also wanted to say really quickly that if and when you do come out to people, the ways that they respond are not your responsibility. How people choose to act or react and the things that they do, do not let them blame you for it. It is not your fault. People's reactions are their own responsibilities. You're just trying to navigate this world and be your actual self. And so for that, I applaud you. And I just wanted to make it clear to you that you are not a sin, you are not doing something wrong, and you are not responsible for other people's narrow-mindedness or reactions. So all my love, I wish you nothing but the best. Peace.
Good morning. My name is Joao. I am an ordained minister with the Fellowship of Affirming Ministries, and I'm also a member with the United Church of Christ. Both are affirming to all people. I'm sending this message today to let you know that you are beautifully and wondrously made by God. Make no mistake about it. God intended to make you exactly who you are, how you are. God knew you before you were created in your mother's womb. In fact, God formed you in your mother's womb. I am an openly same-gender loving man, and I've struggled with my sexuality for a long time, mainly because of the hatred that I was taught and all those negative things that was embedded in me.
I'd just like to take a minute and offer some words of encouragement to my lesbian, gay, bisexual, transgender questioning friends who are struggling with how their sexual identity might conflict with their faith identity. First of all, it's okay. It's okay to struggle. It's okay to question, to feel conflicted, to hurt, to cry. That's okay. You are made in the image of God, just as you are. You are a child of God. God loves you exactly the way that you are. I can't imagine how tough this is for you right now. But I would just like to encourage you to offer some compassion to yourself. Extend some grace to yourself. Be patient with yourself. And embrace who you are as you are. And recognize that you're important. You are important.